Have you ever wondered why women in black and white films are so especially captivating? With the inability to film in color due to the lack of technology, set designers and costume designers surely had to make women and the set stand out in some way. It was imperative they create an atmosphere that was still engaging without the use of color. The most common ways to achieve both was through careful composition, texture, and the use of light and shadow. Here in this video, I will be diving specifically into the last one. If something doesn't catch your eye with color, surely light interplay will. Why do you think all of the most intriguing shots of women incorporate a dress that shimmers in the stage lights? Women are also often juxtaposed with the men, dressed in matted black and gray suits or a darkened set. If women are to be dressed darkly, then they are put in a lighter atmosphere, or one that helps them stand out. A woman of importance, such as a main character, is always difficult to turn away from, with sumptuous fabrics like silks and velvets, complemented by furs and topped off with glimmering jewelry. This is all form following function, right? I mean, the costume designers were certainly successful at making black and white films enjoyable to look at while being at a disadvantage. But what is it about these tricks of the eye that seem to say something more? Why is it that women in black and white films are so much more enchanting than they are in color? I would argue that black and white films bring out the innate magic in femininity. That women filmed in black and white with their fluorescent white blonde hair, their sparkling ensembles, shining skin, and the dimly lit interiors they peruse have unconsciously been sporting the core principles of their feminine nature. Before we can proceed, let me give you some background on how I would define femininity. Women since early Mesopotamia were associated with the moon and its phases because of its syncing with the feminine bodily cycles. It was understood as well that the female's wayward nature mimics the moon's waning and waxing. The moon is covered fully or partially by shadow at all times, and this was deeply symbolic of women's psyche and sexuality. There's always a portion of femininity that is in the shadows, mystery and spontaneity being our specialty. The female throughout all of known history is also represented by nature. She is literally bound by nature through fertility and embodies nature's abundance and its chaos. The feminine is also the merciless, uncanny, indifferent mother nature that wreaks havoc through force majeure, the ocean being a specified area of female dominance. The reason men are often silently terrified of women is because we represent the unknown, which makes them uneasy. The unknown is chaos by virtue of lack of identification. But without getting too ahead of myself, femininity begets seclusion and showmanship. It means showing what you want and hiding what you want. Like the moon, a portion is always hidden. But the other half that peeks out will surely dazzle you. There are two kinds of light interplay I want to focus on, and I will use costume design as a case study. You have shimmer, as I like to call it, the kind of godlike light show, and you have shadow, an allusion to Mother Nature. Let's say these two are the yin and yang of female principles translated into film, of heaven and of earth. Both shimmer and shadow work on evasive tactics. They're both agents of the unknown, but with different outcomes. Femininity does not allow the observer full disclosure. The ball is always in the woman's court. Due to this secrecy, women are either deified or desired. Deification falls under shimmer and represents to me a kind of separation, even if it is for only a moment, from the physical form. This is translated into image by the scenes in which these women wear sparkling dresses. The light reflects off of the stones and sequins, creating distracting and often hypnotizing refractions, like a god passing through the ether to descend upon earth. Shimmer forces the audience to witness her feminine essence, rather than the suggestiveness of her body. Desire, on the other hand, deals directly with the body. We are back to Mother Nature. If the woman is representing a carnal desire or a conservative disposition, she will be subdued in velvets and silks and dark colors. Obscurity and illusion fall under shadow, and the use of form to be direct or indirect. One of the best representations of shadow would be the illusionist-like bodycon dresses, meaning to accentuate certain parts of the body and to hide others, and maybe even the addition of a netted pillbox hat veiling her face. Shining, finger-waved hair and makeup also fall under this kind of light interplay, as they are practices of mirage. In light of the forces at work in black and white films, it is also fair to mention briefly that set design is incredibly important to the display of these women. The stage, the boudoir, and anything dealing with water, I would say, are the most important symbolically. The stage works under shimmer as a place of worship. Water and the boudoir work under shadow as the hidden female-dominated underbellies. Otherwise, the set often works to simply accentuate the form of the women in film. Black and white film does something for femininity that I can't quite find anywhere else. The culture and relationship between the sexes during this era of films certainly contributed to how these women were translated on screen, as well as the genius that came from making do with the technology they had. But there is a kind of grandeur in the simplicity that really begs me to think there are ancient forces at work. A kind of subconscious projection of this innate knowledge. The women in these films are not just being gorgeous in pretty dresses and diamonds, a femme fatale or a femme inspiratrice. They represent unshakable constants, laws that surpass physics, truth. Beauty. All right, that's the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you watched all the way to the end, thank you so much. If you liked this video, leave a like, leave a comment, how you felt about it, you know, what your take is on this, because this is totally like a theory of mine. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you want to see more of this kind of thing. So, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day or evening, and I will see you guys next week. See ya!